Well, he had more than a vague idea that was coming, but as dictators often do, Muammar Gaddafi is refusing to back down. In the process, of course, blaming everyone but himself. But with Western fighter jets, warships and submarines currently attacking his loyal armed forces, what chance the lunatic Libyan leader could survive, literally, politically or militarily? Which raises the crux question. What exactly is the West's mission in Libya? 6pm's Hamish McDonald reports.
Tracer fire lights up Tripoli. A second night of airstrikes pound the capital. French jets began the onslaught. American cruise missiles did much of the damage. This operation, they say, is not about regime change. Nonetheless, they went straight for Gaddafi's compound. Outside of Benghazi, government soldiers inside these vehicles were killed in a precision attack. There's little sympathy from the rebels. They say they're mercenaries. But among the dead are conscripts, given little choice about their part in this war. The scale and severity of the coalition attacks has dismayed some. The Arab League, which initially supported the action, providing crucial legitimacy, has now condemned it.
What happened is different from the objectives we set. We need to be protecting civilians, not bombing more civilians.
Allied strikes have bombed Libyan government positions in Zuwara, Tripoli, Mitiga, Misrata, Sirte and Benghazi. British submarines have launched Tomahawk missiles against Libyan air defence systems, while French and American planes have bombarded tanks and airfields. The US, keen to emphasise this is not its fight alone, is actually leading the operation for now.
We expected in a matter of days to be able to turn over the primary responsibility to others. We will continue to support the coalition. We will be a member of the coalition. We will have a military role in the coalition, but we will not have the preeminent role.
Despite what might seem like evidence to the contrary, they are ruling out going after Gaddafi directly.
The one thing that there is common agreement on are the terms set forth in the Security Council resolution. If we start adding additional objectives, then I think we create a problem.
Defense Secretary Robert Gates, said to be the most reluctant figure in the Obama administration to enforce this no-fly zone, is fearful of getting dragged into an expensive military stalemate. That already seems to be a real possibility. Gaddafi is vowing to cling on. This whole operation could well conclude without him being removed from power. That would leave the West policing a divided Libya. Gaddafi's son, Saif, today warned the coalition they are backing the wrong side.
Believe me, one day you wake up and you will find out that you were supporting the wrong people. And you are doing a big mistake with supporting those people. It's like the WND in Iraq. Right.
The West will be hoping this conflict doesn't go on quite that long.
And our senior foreign correspondent Hamish McDonald joins us now from Dubai. Hamish, could you sum it up for me as you read it there? Is this about, if you like, protecting Libyan lives or regime change? Because it's confusing from this distance.
Well, George, I think that's the central question at this point, because clearly the stated aim of the UN resolution, the mandate, if you like, for this no-fly zone is to prevent the loss of civilian lives in Libya. That's what the West will tell you. The United States, Britain, France, all of the countries leading this operation say that this is not about regime change. But certainly there are already questions rising up as a result of the attacks overnight, particularly the ones that targeted directly Gaddafi's compound in the capital, Tripoli, about whether or not the broader aim of this is in fact regime change. We've already heard the head of the Arab League, as mentioned in our piece, then questioning all of this and suggesting perhaps that already these countries, the allied forces, are acting beyond their mandate. And we've also heard from Russia too, a crucial voice, as we know, at the UN Security Council, saying that they want to stop any civilians from losing their lives. And we have at the same time the Libyan government, the Libyan authorities, saying that about 64 civilians have been killed so far as a result of these attacks. I think legitimacy is really important here, George.
So what difference is all this going to make to getting rid of Muammar Gaddafi, if that's what it's all about?
Well, I mean, it may be that this operation completes without the removal of Muammar Gaddafi, and that's something that the world must really accept, because even at the highest levels of the US military, there isn't a clear willingness to see him removed. We know, for example, that Bob Gates, the US Defense Secretary, has been very reluctant about this whole thing, that it was perhaps the Secretary of State, Hillary Clinton, that was pushing the whole concept of a no-fly zone. They don't want to see themselves engaged in a long and protracted stalemate in the Arab world. So questions there about how long and to what extent foreign forces are willing to commit to this. We're being told that it could be just a matter of days before the European countries involved take the lead in the operations. There's a push to get NATO to take the leadership.
Hamish, I think a little clearer than I was when we started, but we'll stay in touch. And after the program, you can get Hamish on Twitter to answer your questions about the Libyan conflict and its ramifications for the region. As Hamish and I were discussing, there are increasing concerns about just where the intervention in Libya is headed and how it will end. Meanwhile, will the US and its allies send in ground troops? Will the no-fly zone be effective? What of Gaddafi's obstinance? Well, earlier I spoke with strategic and defence expert Professor Clive Williams from our Canberra Bureau. Professor, after a couple of weeks of dilly-dallying, I guess we can say, by the international community, intervention is now on. I guess the basic question is, will it work?
Well, it'll probably work in the sense that it'll prevent attacks on civilians around Benghazi, but in the sense of regime displacement, then I don't think it will work.
Is it regime change, or is it just protecting Libyan lives?
Well, I think the UK and France have particularly want to get rid of Gaddafi because they've tied themselves in closely with the opposition. I think the Americans are a bit more dissembling. Although Obama and Hillary Clinton have said that they want to get rid of Gaddafi, I noticed that in the statements by the military that they're saying that that's not what they're about. They're preventing attacks on civilians. It's humanitarian. That's about it. So there's a difference, I think, of perspective from the UK, France and the United States.
Does that make it difficult as an exercise then that the if you like, the nations who are involved in this so-called coalition or allied alliance, whatever we call it, aren't agreed on exactly what the purpose of the exercise is, what the end result is, getting rid of the guy literally or just applying pressure?
Yeah, I think the UK and France, I think, are more focused ultimately on the oil issues and the arms market, whereas I don't think that's so much the issue for America. I think America is a bit more nervous about this having knock-on effects in other places like Bahrain and Yemen and Saudi Arabia. And so I think that they would be probably happy enough to see some sort of situation in Libya where there's maybe reconciliation or partition, something along those lines, but not necessarily seeing the regime collapse.
Will an all-out assault, if you like, on the ground against Gaddafi be necessary if this is going to work, if this is going to get rid of him and not just the airstrikes? Is it ultimately going to become almost hand-to-hand, if you like?
Well, you could target him with airstrikes, but they've ruled that out. And the Resolution 1973 excludes ground activity. So at the moment, under the current resolution, there can't be really an effective way of getting rid of Gaddafi other than by killing him with airstrikes. And as I say, that's, I think, been ruled out.
Thanks very much for that, Professor. Thank you.
My pleasure, George.
Meanwhile, you can watch it pretty much live on your flat screen at home in the living room. Times are changing.